What if you could bring five artists that lived 500 years apart back to life using AI? What would they create?
I think AI will infuse intelligence in almost every part of our life.
We could definitely have done this in an easier way, but what's the fun in that?
If it's art or not, I let someone else to decide that.
AI's been around for a long time. It's always been about trying to get machines to do something in an intelligent way. The idea of creating a real-world statue that is designed by AI is quite novel. Rather than designing an AI system from scratch that went from concept to statue, we decided to use many AI systems so that we could iterate and continuously improve what came out. You know, the AI can spit out images that are very visually compelling, but that doesn't mean that they can actually work in real life. To arrive at a statue that could actually be machined in stainless steel, there were a number of super interesting challenges that I had to work through with the engineers at Sandvik.
In this particular case study, we have to have really precise digital simulation.
Digital manufacturing has enabled us to prove out the whole process beforehand. This means that we don't need any time on the machine other than the actual production time. This has also enabled us to not produce a single scrap component over this whole project.
We have treated the statue as it would have been really complex or expensive parts, for example, in the aerospace industry. For this project, we chose to use Alemas stainless steel, a hard-to-machine material, just to show what we are able to do.
The initial model that we got from the AI process, for some time we really thought that we won't be able to work with this one. But with the possibility of generating drive surfaces within MasterCAM, we didn't really need to drive on the model itself.
MasterCAM Miochen solution, it simplifies programming processes for these complex machines. The tool paths are optimized and synchronized in a graphical user interface, and then the machining processes are visualized, simulated, and collision checked in one single platform.
We haven't really had any large setback during machining. And I think it's largely thanks to the digital twin technology.
In the working with the impossible statue, we have really been able to use our core competences, using technology, combining that with art, and also using our competences in machining in order to create such a complex statue.
The impossible statue demonstrates our ability to create highly automated processes, from design, data and planning, to machining and verification.
This statue was made from a model that consisted of 9 million polygons. We decided to machine it in full human size. This would have led us to use over 8 tons of material. But with some clever manufacturing tricks, we actually were able to reduce this 8 tons down to 2.5. And when we reach our end result, we really want to check that it's within the quality that we want. And this is where metrology comes in.
We are measuring parts in order to verify if there are inside specifications and to give quality indicators on any parts.
The future of manufacturing is forming with and around us, and we truly enjoy to capture these possibilities together with our customers.
When I saw this statue come out of the AI system, I immediately knew that this was the one. I could recognize all the artists in it, and I love the pose.
I think the statue is a real achievement when it comes to the engineering skills that it's put into it.
We made this all possible, first by using AI to synthesize all the artists, and then using Sandvik's digital twin technology to make sure that the statue was actually manufacturable.
Looking back on the projects, I feel proud. I feel glad that we have finalized it.
I mean, what happens if you ask an AI to combine artists that are that different in their expressive style? It's sort of an impossible statue.